Good morning. Welcome to St. Mary's Penart here on Trinity Sunday, a very special celebration for our church. Today we will follow the service for the act of spiritual communion, a time of sharing together, a time of giving thanks to God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, and exploring the mystery of what it is to follow and worship and be in relationship with the God who is both creator, acceptor and strengthener. We meet in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Jesus, Saviour of the world, we thank you that in this wonderful sacrament of Holy Communion, you have left us a memorial of your passion. Grant us so to reverence the sacred mysteries of your body and blood, that we may know within ourselves the fruit of your redeeming love, who live and reign with the Father and the Holy Spirit, one God for ever and ever. Amen. Listen now to the Gospel of Christ according to St. John. I am the true vine, and my Father is the vine dresser. Every branch in me that does not bear fruit he takes away, and every branch that does bear fruit he prunes, that it may bear more fruit. Abide in me, and I in you, as the branch cannot bear fruit by itself, unless it abides in the vine, neither can you, unless you abide in me. I am the vine, you are the branches. Whoever abides in me, and I in him, he is that bear fruit, much fruit. For apart from me you can do nothing. If you abide in me, and my word abides in you, ask whatever you wish, and it will be done for you. By this my Father is glorified, that you bear much fruit, and so prove to be my disciples. As the Father has loved me, so I have loved you. Abide in me. If you keep my commandments, you will abide in my love, just as I have kept my Father's commandments and abide in his love. These things I have spoken to you, that my joy may be in you, and that your joy may be full. This is the Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, O Christ. We offer up to God all our worries, hopes and fears and failings, for we are a people, a human people. We only have to look at the world around us to realize that we fail. We fail in our humanity, we fail in our compassion, we fail in our acceptance and our forgiveness. And so we bring these things to God this day. Heavenly Father, we have sinned in thought, word and deed, and have failed to do what we ought to have done. We are sorry and truly repent for the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, who died for us. Forgive us all that is past and lead us in his way, to walk as children of light. Amen. Almighty God, forgives all who truly repent. Have mercy on us and set us free from sin. Strengthen us in goodness and keep us in eternal life through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Today, as I said, is Trinity Sunday, and the Gospel reading for today I will give you now. It comes from the Gospel of Matthew. Now the 11 disciples went to Galilee, to the mountain to which Jesus had directed them. When they saw him, they worshipped him, but some doubted. And Jesus came and said to them, "All authority on heaven and on earth has been given to me. Go therefore and make disciples of all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit, and teaching them to obey everything that I have commanded you. And remember, I am with you always to the end of the age." This is the Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, O Christ. Trinity Sunday has been described as the preacher's nightmare. How can you explain God as three persons when he is only one God? God in three persons, blessed Trinity, we sing, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Books have been written upon it. So many words have been preached upon it. And yet, it is something we still grapple with. It is still one of those great mysteries. Perhaps it is easier to see it this way. God as creator, Christ as the Son who brings acceptance and forgiveness, God as Holy Spirit that brings encouragement and strength. And we celebrated Pentecost Sunday last week, that coming of the Holy Spirit into God's church. The first reading we had this morning, the first gospel reading from John, talked about abiding, living in. God's word lives in us. It lives in us through his Holy Spirit. It becomes alive in us through his Holy Spirit. But how did we receive God's word? We received God's word through the teachings of his Son, Jesus. So God and Christ therefore live in us through his word, through his Spirit, abiding in us, living with us so that we may indeed go out and do what we are called to do, living within us so that it brings comfort and hope to us through the pages of Scripture. And the reading from Matthew's Gospel is part of that great commission that tells us as a church to go out into the world and baptize in the name of a God who is the Father, Creator, the Son, the Forgiver, and the Spirit, the Strengthener. Father, Son, and Holy Spirit live within us through the Spirit, through the word of Jesus, through God's creation, of which you and I are a part. We are part of a creation, a cosmic creation, and therefore we live under that love, that word of God made flesh in Jesus. And we are strengthened and encouraged by the presence of his Spirit abiding, that word again, abiding within us. So may the Lord bless us this day, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, in the hearing of his word, in the indwelling of the Spirit, and the love, compassion, and the acceptance of his Son, Jesus. Amen. These are words of comfort of our Lord and Saviour, Jesus Christ, that indeed should abide within us this day. Come to me, all who labour and are heavy laden, and I will give you rest. God so loved the world that he gave his only Son, that whoever believes in him should not perish, but have eternal life. Listen also to what St. Paul said. This saying is trustworthy and deserving of full acceptance, that Christ Jesus came into the world to save sinners. That's you and me. Absolutely. Listen also what St. John says. If anyone does sin, we have an advocate, whom the Father, Jesus Christ, the righteous. He is the one that takes away our sins. He is the bridge between us and God the Father, to whom we confess and receive forgiveness. The Eucharist, the holy meal of bread and wine, is very special to Christians throughout the world. And of course, at the moment, in churches, it cannot be received because our churches are closed for public worship. But we can think about what that may mean to those of you who normally receive it regularly. That special place it holds for you. That meal that strengthens by the presence of Christ's Spirit. O blessed Lord, in union with the faithful throughout the world, at every altar of your church where the Eucharist is celebrated, we desire to offer you praise and thanksgiving. We present to you our souls and our bodies with the earnest wish that we may always be united to you. Since we cannot now receive you in the sacrament, we invite you to come spiritually into our hearts. We unite ourselves to you and embrace you with heart and mind and soul. Let nothing ever separate us from you, so that we may live and die in your love. Amen. Soul of Christ, sanctify us. Body of Christ, save us. Blood of Christ, refresh us. Water from the side of Christ, wash us. Passion of Christ, strengthen us. Within your wounds, hide us. Do not permit us to be separated from you, and from the malicious enemy, defend us. In the hour of our deaths, call us. And bid us come to you, that with all the saints we may praise you ever and ever. Amen. May the Lord bless you. Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, God in three persons, blessed Trinity, this Trinity Sunday and all days to come. Amen.